Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asian Newsline, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 8th of July. Prime Minister Modi embarks on three-day official visit to Russia and Austria. Pakistanis laments tax terror as government scrambles to boost revenue. And at least 62 people dead in Nepal due to heavy rains, threatening landslides, lightning strikes. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi embarked on a three-day official visit to Russia and Austria on Monday. The first leg of the visit, he will make a pit stop in Moscow, where he is scheduled to hold the 22nd annual summit between India and Russia. The summit, which will be chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Russian President Vladimir Putin, will review a range of bilateral issues including defence, trade linkages, investment ties, energy cooperation, education, culture and people-to-people exchanges. Later on Tuesday, the Indian Prime Minister is scheduled to lay a wreath at the tomb of the unknown soldier in the Kremlin, followed by a delegation-level talk with the Russian President. In the second leg of his two-nation visit, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be arriving in Austria at the invitation of the Chancellor of Austria. The visit by the Prime Minister to the Central European country will be the first from any Indian PM in 41 years. In twin operations in India's Jammu and Kashmir this past weekend, security forces neutralized 6 terrorists. The encounters began on Saturday in Chinigam and Modagam villages of Kulgam district, based on intelligence regarding the presence of terrorists. Following this, joint operations were launched by the security forces in both villages, which are situated 20 kilometers apart. Jammu and Kashmir Police Chief R. R. Swan called the operation a big milestone in improving the security environment. While officials confirmed 6 terrorists were killed, 2 Indian Army soldiers, Lance Nayak Pradeep Kumar and Sipoy Praveen Janjal Prabhakar, were also killed in action.
निसंदेह ये एक बहुत बड़ा माइलस्टोन है, बहुत बड़ा प्रोग्रेस है सिक्योरिटी एनवायरनमेंट में मजबूती लाने के लिए। ये सक्सेसेस बहुत मायने रखते हैं और एक सब्सटेंटिव तौर पे भी और एक मैसेजिंग के तौर पे भी।
As Pakistan continues to suffer high inflation and heavy taxes, Pakistan's Finance Minister Mohammad Aurangzeb has warned that the country will continue to seek IMF bailouts if it fails to bring the tax revenue up. A report.
As Pakistan grapples with high inflation, Finance Minister Mohammad Aurangzeb warned on Sunday that the country would continue to seek bailouts from IMF if it fails to boost tax revenue. Speaking to a UK-based media outlet, the Financial Times, Aurangzeb said he was relatively confident in reaching a staff-level agreement with the global lender for an estimated loan of $6 to $8 billion. However, he added that this wouldn't be Pakistan's last program if they don't bring the tax revenue up. He emphasized that Pakistan does not have 5 years. They need to show result in the next 2 to 3 months. The government has set an ambitious tax revenue target of 13 trillion Pakistani rupees for the fiscal year starting July 1st. A near 40% increase from the previous year. While the IMF approves of this ambitious target, it faces criticism from the opposition, trade unions, government allies and the public, who are angered by the new taxes. Residents lamenting the annual budget have said Pakistan used to suffer from external terrorism, but now they face tax terror from their own government. They allege that while Pakistan continues to borrow from foreign lenders and impose heavy taxes on lower income groups, only the elites and state officials continue to enjoy the benefits.
हर तरह की तकलीफ ये कौम उठा सकती है, लेकिन आप सारे पैसे कर्जों के लिए दें और गरीब आवाम से लेके दें, खुद आप अपनी कोई अय्याशी छोड़ने के लिए तैयार ना हो तो ये अब आवाम बर्दाश्त नहीं करेगी।
बिजली के बिल, गैस के बिल और टैक्सेस की भरमार, आम बंदा पिस के रह गया। लोगों के अंदर सकत नहीं है इस बोझ को मजीद उठा सके, जबकि जो हमारे हुक्मरान हैं वो ये बात समझ रहे हैं कि शायद कर्ज लेके और दुनिया के इन अदारों से सूद पे कर्ज लेके मुल्क चला लेंगे। मैं ये समझता हूँ कि पाकिस्तान के अवाम अब इस अय्याशी को जो हमारे हुक्मरान कर रहे हैं, हमारा माफिया कर रहा है, अशराफिया कर रहा है, इसको कबूल करने के लिए तैयार नहीं है।
Despite international concern, nearly 2,000 Afghan migrants have been expelled from Pakistan and Iran through various border points, officials have said. The wave of Afghan migrant deportation, especially from Pakistan, has increased in recent months amidst dire humanitarian condition in Afghanistan and ongoing security threats. The deportations are seen as exacerbating an already dire situation, forcing vulnerable individuals back into a country ill-prepared to support them. Reports suggest many of the deported migrants face challenges upon return, including a lack of shelter, livelihood opportunities, and access to basic services such as healthcare and education. This continues despite UN concerns over already worsening humanitarian and economic conditions in Afghanistan. The de facto Taliban authorities have denounced the deportations. Sri Lanka has decided to lift a ban from next year on the visit of foreign research ships, which was imposed after concerns raised by US and India following frequent docking requests from high-tech Chinese surveillance vessels. With increased movement of Chinese research vessels in the Indian Ocean, New Delhi had expressed concern that those might be spy ships and urged Colombo not to allow such vessels to dock at its ports. After India raised concern, Sri Lanka banned the entry of foreign research vessels from docking at its port earlier this year. It had made an exception for a Chinese vessel but said the ban would continue otherwise. Foreign Minister Ali Sabri said the government cannot impose different rules for different countries and only block China. He further added that the island nation will not take sides in a dispute between others. As many as 62 people have killed and 90 others were injured after heavy monsoon rains in Nepal triggered flash floods, landslides and lightning strikes. Severe flooding in capital city Kathmandu inundated streets, rendering homes and vehicles underwater, forcing residents to wade through brown flood water to go about their daily task. Reports suggested the flood and landslides have caused damage equivalent to 8 million and 600,000 rupees so far. Residents lamented they are forced to leave their homes and their children are already suffering with chronic illnesses.
हिजो देखि पानी पर्यो अस्ति देखि पानी पर्यो तर आजको गम्भीर समस्या छ तपाईको बाल बच्चा देखि लिएर तपाईको चाहिँ मुटुका रोगीहरु छन् वर्षौने बारी डुबानमा पर्छ तर अहिले असारमै परेको हुनाले किन भन्नुहुन्छ नि अहिले तपाईको झन्नै झन्नै घुरा घुरा आइसक्यो रातभरि पर्यो भने बस्ती खतराको घन्टीमा छ।
Landslides and flash floods are common in mostly mountainous Nepal during the monsoon season and kill hundreds of people every year. The annual monsoon rains, which started since mid-June, would normally continue until mid-September. Millions of devotees from across the country gathered in Puri district of India's eastern Odisha state as the 9-day-long Jagannath Puri Rath Yatra or Chariot Festival commenced on Sunday. The chariots carrying idols of the Holy Trinity, Hindu god Lord Jagannath and his siblings Balbhadra, Devi Subhadra were decked in bright colors and adorned with flowers as the gods set out for their journey. Devotees jostled with each other to touch the over 40 feet high chariot amid chants and beats of gongs while artists performed folk dances. The festival commemorates the annual journey of the deities in special chariots to Gundicha Temple, situated 2 kilometers away from the Puri Jagannath Temple. Hindus consider a glimpse of Lord Jagannath as auspicious and consider the chariot festival to be a divine moment where the Lord himself comes to bless his devotees on the street.
The Rath Yatra or the car festival, popularly known in English, is not merely a festival, it is a sentiment. It is not just a sentiment for 4.5 crore Odias, but for all Hindus worldwide. Lord of the universe, Lord Jagannath, he leaves his abode and he visits his devotees. He gives darshan to his devotees on the streets. Lakhs of people come and they all get together in Puri.
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night and take care.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.